You know the main problem with the theory of evolution? It insults the monkeys.
That's true. See? Look at this. So the monkeys are, the apes are up there saying, no way! This is evolution. This is devolution. There you go.
Okay, but that's not what I want to talk to you today about. That's just a little sign, you know, evolution. Who cares? Come on, who cares? Okay, look at, the thing I want to talk about is this. A lady wrote me recently and says, I listened to your sermon, Shadow Activity. And it seems to me that you are repeating the heresy of Marcion of old. Is this true? And the answer is no. God bless you. Have a great day. Bye-bye. No. I'm not. Look at Marcion was this second century heretic, and he rightly saw, he had something right, he rightly saw that the revelation of God in Christ was incompatible with the violent portraits of God in the Old Testament. We got to give him credit for that. Unfortunately, he wrongly concluded that therefore we must reject the Old Testament. And he thought the Old Testament was written by a different God and all sorts of stuff like that. What I'm proposing in my in the sermon Shadow Activity and in various writings that I've done, and I'm working on with this book, The Crucifixion of the Warrior God, it has nothing to do with Marcion. It is the alternative to Marcion. It is following in the footsteps of Origen and Gregory of Nyssa and John Cassian in the early church, who understood that while there's this incompatibility between the God revealed in Jesus Christ and the violent portraits of God in the Old Testament, rejecting the Old Testament is not an option. And so what they saw is that we need to look at these portraits through the lens of Christ and reinterpret them in light of Christ. But I don't regard rejecting any part of the Old Testament as an option at all. It's divinely inspired. And my main reasons for believing that, I've got a number of reasons, but my main reasons is because Jesus clearly saw the Old Testament as being divinely inspired. And since I've got very good reasons for believing he is the embodiment of Yahweh on earth, I seriously doubt he was wrong about that. And so I feel obliged, as much as aspects of the Old Testament grieve me when I read it, I feel obliged to confess that it is God-breathed, as Paul says in 2 Timothy 3:16. The essence of my proposal is just this. We have got the definitive revelation of God in Jesus Christ, and if Jesus reveals, especially if Jesus on the cross reveals what God is really like, then we have to read the Bible knowing that, and read the Bible through that lens. And that changes everything. We can see things. We have a perspective that people in the Old Testament did not have. That wisdom that was kept secret for ages and generations, as Paul says, they didn't know about. Now, it's revealed in Christ, but they didn't know about it. The wisdom of God was hidden from them. And so the way they interpret events, the things that they say about God, are going to be penultimate. That is to say, they don't give the ultimate, or at least they don't consistently give the ultimate perspective on things. We reading the Bible through the lens of Christ can know things that they didn't know. And so we can discern in their writings things that they didn't even see. God's breathing through them in ways that they weren't even aware of. And that's what the book, The Crucifixion of the Warrior God, is all about. I'll give you one example. I think everything should be based on the cross, since the cross is the quintessential revelation of God. And so when we look at the cross, ask yourself the question, how is it that we see God's heart revealed there? We don't see God revealed on the surface of the cross, just in terms of what we behold. What we behold with our eyes is a criminal, a God-forsaken criminal, being crucified on a cross. That's what we see. If you're looking at it from what Paul calls a worldly point of view in 2 Corinthians 5, you would never see that as a revelation of God. You'd only see, I mean, all the folks who saw this criminal, they didn't see God revealed there. They just saw a criminal being crucified there. We see the revelation of God when we look with the eyes of faith, spirit-empowered eyes of faith. We look through the surface of the cross, and we behold in the depths of the cross a God who's humbly condescending to bear our sin and therefore take on an appearance that reflects our sin more than it does his own character. Think about that. So with the eyes of faith, we see through the cross. It's not the surface that reveals God. It's the God behind the surface stooping to take on that surface appearance. And that's when it becomes revelatory for us. Now, if that's what God is really like, it's what God's always been like, and therefore we have to read the Bible knowing that. And so we should read the Bible knowing that there may be times when it's not the surface of the text that reveals God. It's rather when we reinterpret these texts with the same faith we have in the crucified Christ, and therefore we look beyond the surface and behold a God who stoops to take on, to bear the sin of his people and take on an appearance that reflects their sin more than it does his true character. It becomes revelatory. And when we read the Bible through that lens, it changes everything. It changes everything. And now you can begin to understand how it is that all Scripture bears witness to the crucified Christ, as Jesus himself says it must in Luke 24. All Scripture, even the violent portraits of God, the portrait of God commanding genocide, it bears witness to the crucified Christ. But it only does that when we read it through the lens of the crucified Christ. Hopefully I've given you some things to think about. God bless you. Whatever else you think, whether you accept this or not, keep your eyes fixed on Jesus Christ, the author and finisher of our faith, the one true, perfect expression of God's hypostasis, his very essence. That is what God is like. God bless.